Good morning to all of you. I welcome to all in our lecture series on mathematical physics, and we are discussing the unit 2 belongs to the topic second order differential equation with variable coefficient and its solution by power series method. And this is our lecture number 31. In our last class we have been discussed about Fournier's series solution method, and we done a problem that is the differential equation is x y double dash, which is function of x 2 y dash plus x y equal to 0, and the Fournier's method solutions power series solution step by step we done for this problem. And here we found that if a differential equation have regular singular point, then we can consider the Fournier series method. Okay, in step by step we discussed this problem in our last class, so I suggest to all of you that you have to go through that last video, that is lecture number 30. So in this class or in this video we are going to discuss another problem, that is using Fournier's method find the series solution of the differential equation 4x double dash plus 2y dash plus y equal to 0. Here y is the function of x. I not written, but here you have to consider y is the function of x. So before we have to proceed with the Fournier's method, first we have to check that this differential equation have singular point or not. So here if we have to divide 4x in each term, we can found y double dash plus 2y dash by 4x plus y by 4x equal to 0. Here px will be 2 by 4x, that is 1 by 2x, and qx will be equal to 4 by 1 by 4x. Okay, both px and qx will be tends to infinite if we are going to consider x tends to 0. That means if we are going to put x equal to 0, px will be infinite and qx will be infinite. That means x equal to 0 is a regular singular point of the given differential equation. So power series solution can be obtained by using Fournier's method. So as this differential equation have regular singular point at x equal to 0, then we can consider Fournier's method. Okay, and this equation is considered as equation number 1. Now as per the rule, here we have to assume the Fournier series solution of the differential equation in the form of y equal to x to the power k, summation over n is equal to 0 to infinity, an x to the power n. Let this is equation number 2, or this can be written as summation over n is equal to 0 to infinity, an x to the power n plus k. Let this is equation number 2a. Now we have to consider the first derivative of this one. It will be summation over 0 to infinity n plus k an x to the power n plus k minus 1. Let it is equation number 3. And y double dash will be summation over n equal to 0 to infinity n plus k, here n plus k minus 1, into an into x to the power n plus k minus 2. Let it is equation number 4. Now we have to put the values of equation 2a, that is y value, y double dash value, y double dash value in equation number 1. So here I written that equation 2a, 3 and 4, these 3 value we have to put in equation number 1. Our equation number 1 is this one. Okay, now we have to put here values, that means 4x y double dash. So 4x is here, y double dash we found this much. We have to substitute, nothing else. So 0 to infinity n plus k into n plus k minus 1 an, see this one I just substituted over here, n plus k minus 1 into an into x to the power n plus k minus 2. Then in equation number 1 it is 2 into y dash, so 2 is here, y dash means this one, that is summation over 0 to infinity n plus k an x to the power n plus k minus 1, x to the power n plus k minus 1. Then plus y equal to 0, plus y, y means 0 to infinity summation over n x to the power n plus k equal to 0. Okay, now it can be written as, see here x is there means x to the power 1, here x to the power n plus k minus 2, so it will be the power will be add up, then it will be x to the power n plus k minus 1. So 4 is here, as usual 4 is written here, and then summation over 0 to infinity n plus k n plus k n plus k minus 1 n x to the power n plus k minus 2 will be here, here another power 1 is going to be add up here, then it will be x to the power n plus k minus 1. Then plus 2 summation over 0 to infinity n plus k an x to the power n plus k minus 1, and another term, third term is 0 to infinity summation over an x to the power n plus k equal to 0. Now this is nothing. Now here you can see in this two term, in this two term, what are the common factors among these two term, first term and second term. Here you can see n plus k an x to the power n plus k minus 1 are common in this term and this term, first term and second term. See, n plus k is there, n plus k, an x to the power n plus k minus 1, x to the power n plus k minus 1. So these are the common in between this and this term. So I can take outside, that is an into x to the power n plus k into n plus k minus 1 into n plus k into rest of the things, whatever we have, that is 4 into n plus k minus 1 plus 2, that is 4 into n plus k minus 1 plus 2. Then the last term has been written as usual. The last term is summation over 0 to infinity an x to the power n plus k. Here I written as usual an x to the power n plus k summation over 0 to infinity equal to 0. Now see that in curly bracket here you can found that 4n in plus 4k minus 4, here one minus 4 you can get, plus 2 is there so it will be minus 2, and other things has been written as usual. This is n plus k n plus k, and here 4n plus 4k minus 2, 4n plus 4k minus 2 an x to the power n plus k minus 1, x to the power n plus k minus 1 plus this term an summation over x to the power n plus k equal to 0. Now here in the first term, this term, the power is n plus k minus 1. In the second term, the power is n plus k. So now we have to equalize the power of x of both the terms by considering n is equal to s plus 1 for the first term and n equal to s for the second term. Then what we are going to get? See, in our last class also I have been told that here we have to equalize the power of x by considering this method, okay, that is equalization of power, like method, okay. So here you can see that if we are going to consider n equal to s plus 1, here s plus 1 plus k minus 1, it will be s plus k. Here if we are going to consider n equal to s, it will be x to the power s plus k. So hence, if we have to do so, that is considering n equal to s plus 1 for the first term, n equal to s for the second term, what we are going to get? See, here n, instead of n, I am going to write s plus 1 equal to 0. Here see, s plus 1 equal to 0, that means s equal to minus 1 to infinity. Then n, instead of n, what we are going to write? We can write s plus 1. So s plus 1 plus k is there. Instead of n, it will be written as s plus k. The 4k is there, 4k minus 2 minus 2 into a n. Instead of n, we have to write s plus k into x to the power. Here n is going to be written as s plus 1. S plus 1, see, s plus 1 plus k minus 1 will be s plus k. Okay. Then the second term is s equal to 0 to infinity a s into x to the power s plus k equal to 0. Okay. Now, from the first term, we can found that the series starts from s is equal to minus 1. That means this series starts from s is equal to minus 1, then s is equal to 0, like that up to infinite. So here the second term is starts from s is equal to 0 to infinity. So in this term, the extra term, if we are going to compare this and this first and second term, the extra term in this first term will be for s is equal to minus 1. So here this first series is starts from minus 1, but the second series is starts from s is equal to 0 to infinity. So minus 1 term we have to be extract from this term, then we have to write. So the minus 1 term, s is equal to minus 1 term, we have to separate it out from this first term. Okay. So if we have to put s is equal to minus 1, it will be, see, s minus 1 plus k plus 1 into 4 into s, we have to put minus 1 plus 1 plus 4k is there, 4k minus 2 minus 2 into a. Instead of s, we have to put minus 1 plus 1 into x to the power minus 1 plus k. Then the series will be starts from s is equal to 0 to infinity, as usual, whatever the written here, that is s plus k plus 1 into 4 into s plus 1 plus 4k minus 2, this much, into a s plus 1 into x to the power s plus k, x to the power s plus k, and the second term is s 0 to infinity a s into x to the power s plus k equal to 0. Okay. So further simplification of this, what we are going to get, see, minus 1 plus 1 0, so k will be there, k. Okay. Here minus 1 plus 1, so this will be 0, and the rest things we can get, 4k minus 2, 4k minus 2. Here a minus 1 plus 1 will be a 0, x to the power minus 1 plus k, it will be written as x to the power k minus 1 plus this one. Summation over s equal to 0 to infinity, s plus k plus 1, s plus k plus 1 into, same thing I have been written, 4 into s plus 1 plus 4k minus 2 into a s plus 1 into x to the power s plus k plus second term, this one. Summation over 0 to infinity, as x to the power s plus k equal to 0. See, here I don't have the space, only for that I written adjustly, but you have to write continuously. Okay, this term, this full term is this one. Okay. Now, equating to 0 of the coefficient of x to the power k minus 1, that is lowest power of x. Now, here we got the three terms. This one is one term, this one is another term, this one is another term. If we are going to compare all the terms, this x to the power k minus 1 will be the lowest as compared with this one and this one. So first we have to equate to 0 the coefficient of lowest power of x, then we can found the so called your indicial equation. Here you have to remember, to finding the indicial equation from which we can found the roots, for that you have to always equate. the lowest power of x. Lowest power of x. So here in these three terms, this term have lowest power of x. So now the coefficient of this x to the power k minus 1 is going to be equate to 0. Okay, so if we are going to do so, then what we are going to get? So here this is the coefficient, that is k into 4k minus 2 into a0, that will be equal to 0. So k into 4k minus 2 into a0 equal to 0, let it is equation number 6, and this will be called as your indicial equation. So here a0 is the one type of amplitude term, so it could not be 0. So if a0 could not be 0, then k will be 0 or 4k minus 2 equal to 0 to satisfy this equation. Here a0 is one type of amplitude, so a0 could not be 0. So k equal to 0 or 4k minus 2 equal to 0. So k equal to 0 and 4k minus 2 equal to 0. Here 4k equal to 2 by 4 equal to 1 by 2. So here we got two roots of the initial equation, that is k equal to 0 and k equal to 1 by 2. Okay. So now first we have to rewrite the equation number 5. First, what we done that equating the lowest power of x to 0, then we found the two roots, that is k equal to 0 and k equal to 1 by 2. Then we have to search the second lowest. Searching the second lowest, here I written this full equation number 5 again here. Now rewrite the equation number 5. Here itself you can consider. Okay, so see here x to the power k minus 1 term is there, and here this term and this term have the same power. X power is same. Here x to the power s plus k, here also x to the power s plus k. Okay, the second lowest power of x is this term and this term. Means if we are going to take the x to the power s plus k common, then this coefficient plus this coefficient will be the considered as coefficient of x to the power s plus k. For the simplification, I written equation number 5 once again with addition. See, the first term was k into 4k minus 2 into a0 into x to the power k minus 1, this one I written. Then by taking common x to the power s plus k from this and this term, what we are going to get? See, s plus k plus 1 into 4 s plus k plus 4k minus 2 into a s plus 1, this much plus as. So already here summation is same. See, summation here s equal to 0 to infinity, here also s equal to 0 to infinity. Here power is same. So summation, commonly we can write summation over s equal to 0 to infinity. Then first coefficient is this one, s plus k plus 1 into 4 s plus 1 plus 4k minus 2 into as plus 1 plus as whole into x to the power s plus k, because in these two terms x to the power s plus k is common. For this term x to the power s plus k is there, for this term x to the power k s plus k is there, so I can take common from these two terms. So let this equation number is 7. Okay, so here what we done, that x to the power k plus 1, which is the lowest power of x, and its coefficient when is going to be 0, we found the initial equation and corresponding two roots equal to k equal to 0 and k equal to 1 by 2. And the second lowest of x to the power x power is x to the power s plus k. okay. Then if we are going to be equate to 0 of the coefficient of x to the power s plus k, then what we are going to get? So now equating to 0 of the coefficient of x to the power s plus k. So x to the power s plus k is nothing but second lowest power or highest power among these two terms. Okay, this will be the second lowest. If we are going to consider this one and this one, this will be the second lowest and also highest among this and this. And summation starts from 0 to infinity. So whenever these things you have to remember, whenever you are going to equate the summation coefficient of highest power of x and it starts from s is equal to 0 to infinity, that will be give recursion or recurrence relation. We have to just go back to our last problem, whatever we done, you can confirm. See here in this equation, you can check your note that in these three terms, the lowest is x to the power k plus 2. Whenever we equated this one equal to 0, we found two roots. That is so called indicial equation. Then this is another lowest term, and we equated the coefficient and we found a1 value for k equal to 0, k equal to 0 and k equal to minus 1. But whenever we equated this equal to 0, this coefficient, this is the coefficient which is belongs to highest power of x. See, among these three terms, this will be the highest power of the x, and the series, this series starts from s equal to 0. So whenever this condition you can found and this coefficient whenever is going to be equal to 0, we can found the so called recurrence or recursion relation. Okay, so among these two terms this will be the highest power of the x, and summation starts from s equal to 0 to infinity. So if we are going to equate this coefficient to 0, then we can found the so called recursion or recurrence relation. So here I just written that second power is nothing but so called highest power, as we have to compare this and this term. Okay, so now we have to equate the coefficient to 0. The coefficient is s plus k plus 1 into 4 into s plus 1 plus 4k minus 2 into as plus 1 plus as equal to 0. Same thing I have written here, s plus k minus 1 whole into 4 into s plus 1 plus 4k minus 2 into as plus 1 plus as equal to 0. That implies as plus 1 will be equal to minus as by s plus k. These things is going to be divided to the right side. So s plus k plus 1 into whole into 4 into s plus 1 plus 4k minus 2. Let this equation number is 8, and this is nothing but called as recursion or recurrence relation. Here we got from the initial equation, how many roots we got from the initial equation? We got the two roots, k equal to 0 and k equal to minus 1 by 2. So as we got two k values, so we can get two recursion relation and corresponding series solutions. Okay, for k equal to 0, one series solution we can get, it will be called as y1. For k is equal to 1 by 2, another series solution we can get, it will be called as y2, can be represented by y2. Then general solution will be a y1 plus b y2, that we are going to do now. Okay, and here I can say to you, you have to pause the video and carefully write the note. Here see, many terms are there. If you just miss one bracket, the meaning will be changed. If plus will be minus, the meaning will be changed. And whatever I am doing with pencil, you should not be do. Whatever I written in the pen, you just write. Okay, and put the equation number perfectly. Now, first case we have to consider for k equal to 0, and k equal to 0 and its recurrence or recursion relation and corresponding series solution. This is series, S-E-R-I-S, series solution, corresponding series solution. Okay. So here in equation number 8 we found the general recursion or recurrence relation. So for k equal to 0, what it will be? For k equal to 0, we have to put 0 here and 0 also here. Okay. So a s plus 1 will be equal to, for k equal to 0, the equation number 8, the equation number 8, that is the general recurrence relation, will be a s plus 1 will be equal to minus a s whole divided by c. It will be s plus k plus 1. If we have to put k equal to 0, then it will be s plus 1. I written that much, s plus 1. In the square bracket, what we have? We have 4 into s plus k. 4 into s plus k. Okay. Next, we have here 4 into k. We have to consider k equal to 0. So, this term will be 0. So, 0 and minus 2. Minus 2 is here, minus 2 we are going to be right there. So minus 2, and we can found is equal to minus as whole divided by s plus 1, s plus 1. Here you can see it will be 4s plus 4 minus 2 will be equal to plus 2. So we found as plus 1 will be equal to this much, minus as by s plus 1 into 4s plus 2. Now we have to find out the a1, a2, a3 coefficients by considering different s values. Okay, for s equal to 0, now we have to consider for s equal to 0, for s equal to 0, see, if we have to put s equal to 0 over here, then it will be a1. A1 is equal to, you consider this is the simplification of this one only. It will be, see, in the denominator 4s plus 4 minus 2, just I have been written this one. Okay, you just consider this one. So for s equal to 0, it will be a1 minus, here as means 0, we have to consider a0 whole divided by s equal to 0, that means 1, s equal to 0, that means 2. So 1 into 2, that will be equal to minus a0 by 2. Here you can write also a0 by 2 factorial, no problem. But at the end I written that in the factorial form. So you have to write what I have been written. Okay. Now we have to consider s equal to 1. Okay, s equal to 1 means it will be s equal to 1 plus 1 will be a2. A2 and here minus a1. Minus a1 whole divided by 1, if we are going to put 1 plus 1 will be 2, here 1 if we are going to put, it will be 4 plus 2 will be 6, is equal to, minus is there, a1 value we are going to put directly from here, a1 value how much we got, minus a0 by 2. So a1 value here I substituted minus a0 by 2 into, here the denominator term is 2 into 6. It will be minus minus plus a0 by 6 into 4 will be 24. Gone. Next, s is equal to 2. S is equal to 2 means it will be 2 plus 1 equal to a3. S equal to 2 we are going to put here. It will be minus a2. Minus a2 by 2 plus 1, 3. 2 if we are going to put, it will be 8 plus 2, 10. Okay. So minus will be here, a2 value already we got here, directly I have to put over here, it will be a0 by 24 into the denominator things will be 1 by 3 into 10, it will be minus a0 by it will be, you can found that 720, and so on, means another terms also you can consider. In the exam these three terms is enough to write down the series. No need to extract the other terms, but you have to write, and so on means the other terms can be calculated. Now consider equation number 2 for k equal to 0, and then substitute these above values means a1, a2, a3 values we have to substitute by considering k equal to 0 for equation number 2. What we are going to get? First we have to consider the equation number 2. What is the equation number 2? The equation number 2 is this one, x to the power k summation over 0 to infinity a n x to the power n. So here we have to put instead of k equal to 0. So here the equation number 2 is this one, x to the power k summation over n is equal to 0 to infinity a n x to the power n is equal to x to the power k considered as 0, x to the power 0, 0 to infinity a n x to the power n. Okay, so here for k equal to 0 will be one solution, and k equal to 1 by 2 will be another solution. So let this solution is y1. So y1 will be equal to, just expand this summation as like this, it will be x to the power 0 will be 1, leave it, and this summation is going to be expand like this, n is equal to 0, a0 x to the power 0, a0 x to the power 0 plus a1 x to the power 1, a2 x to the power 2 plus a3 x to the power 3 and so on. And here x to the power 0 will be 1, a0 plus a1x. So we have to consider a1 value is minus a0 by 2. So minus a0 by 2 x. Okay, a2 x square, a2 value is a0 by 24. So a0 by 24 x square. Okay, a3 value is how much? Minus a0 by 720, minus a0 by 720 x to the power 3 and so on. So here we can take common a0 from all the terms. We can found a0 square bracket starts 1 minus x by 2 plus x square by 24 minus x cube by 720 and so on. So this is one solution we got. This is one solution we got by considering k equal to 0. By considering k equal to 0, which is called the case 1. Then we have to consider case 2, that is for k equal to half, 1 by 2, and the corresponding recurrence or recursion relation and corresponding series solution. So this is what we found. This is the series solution of the differential equation for k is equal to 0. Now we have to consider k is equal to 1 by 2. For k is equal to 1 by 2, the equation number 8, what will be in the form, that first we have to write. For k is equal to 1 by 2, what will be the equation number 8? We have to put in equation number 8, instead of k, 1 by 2. It will be minus as whole divided by s plus 1 by 2 plus 1 minus as by s plus 1 by 2 plus 1. Then this is 4 into s plus 1 plus 4. Here we have to put 1 by 2. So here 4 into s plus 1 plus 4 into 1 by 2 minus 2. That will be as plus 1 will be equal to minus as by s plus 3 by 2, 1 by 2 plus 1, 3 by 2 into 4s into 4. Sorry, this will be 4s plus 4 plus 2 minus 2. So plus 2 minus 2 got cancelled. Sorry, it will be 4s plus 4, 4s plus 4, 4s plus 4, 2, 4 into 1 by 2 means 2, this is minus 2, 2 got cancelled, 4s plus 4, 4s plus 4. So this is, these things I written in the next page, because I should not be move once again to the last page. So what I written, that same thing I have been written for my easy explanation, that is as equal to minus as by as plus 1, as plus 3 by 2 into 4s plus 4. So we found that as plus 1 equal to minus as by s plus 3 by 2 into 4s plus 4. That is the so-called recursion relation for k is equal to 1 by 2. See, these things you should not be right. The pencil things, whatever I am writing for you, for the explanation only. No, you should not be right. You have to write wherever I will be do the correction, I will be say at that time. These things, whatever I am writing, no need to be right. Okay. Here I written something. This should not be right in your note. Okay. So now we are going to be put the different values, that is s equal to 0, s equal to 1, s equal to 2, and we can found a1, a2, a3. First we have to put s equal to 0. S equal to 0, if we are going to put, it will be a1 minus equal to minus a0 whole divided by s is 0, it will be 3 by 2. S is 0, it will be 4. 3 by 2 into 4, 2, 2 got cancelled, 3 into 2 equal to 6. So minus a 0 by 6, we found a 1. Now s equal to 1, s equal to 1 means this will be 1 plus 1, 2, a 2, a 2 equal to a 1. Here we consider s is equal to 1, no? So it will be minus minus a 1 whole divided by s will be considered as 1 plus 3 by 2 into 4 into 1 plus k, sorry, plus 4 is equal to minus a 1 divided by this will be 1 plus 3 by 2 is nothing but 5 by 2 into this will be 4 plus 4 is 8. And further simplification, if we are going to do that, a 1 value already we got, that is minus a 0 by 6. You just put over here, that will be minus is here, minus a 1 value. You have to put minus a 0 by 6, minus a 0 by 6 into the denominator terms, that is 1 by 5 by 2 into 8. So 2, 8 is 4. So it will be minus minus plus a 0 by 6, 6, 5, 5, 2 got cancelled, 4. So 6 into 5 into 4 will be a 0 by 120. Got it? Next, for s equal to 2, for s equal to 2, if we are going to put, see, s equal to 2, it will be a 3 minus a 2, a 3 equal to minus a 2 whole divided by s, we have to put how much, 2. So 2 plus 3 by 2 into 4 into s, we have to put 2. 2 plus 4 is equal to a 2 value. I am going to put directly how much I got, a 0 by 120. So a 0 by 120 into the denominator terms will be 1 by, this will be how much, 4, 4 plus 3, 7 by 2, 7 by 2, and this will be 4 into 2, 8 plus 4, 12, okay. So we can get that minus a 0 whole divided by 120 is here, 120, okay, 2 cancelled with 12, it will be 6, 7 into 6, 7 into 6, so it will be minus a 0 by 50, 40. If you are going to multiply this much, you can get 50, 40. Now, and so on. So on means other terms also you can found by considering other s values. If you are going to consider s equal to 3, you can get a 4. S equal to 4, you can found s a 5 like that. No need. These three terms is enough to write the series. Now, what we are going to, considering equation number 2 for k is equal to 1 by 2 and then substituting the substituting these above values, we get the equation number 2 is nothing but y equal to x to the power k summation over 0 to infinity a n into x to the power n. So here instead of k, what we are going to put, we have to put 1 by 2. So x to the power 1 by 2 summation over n equal to 0 to infinity a n x to the power n, or you can write summation over 0 to infinity n equal to 0 to infinity a n, here x to the power n, here x to the power 1 by 2. You can write x to the power 1 by 2 plus n. Now just you have to write this one in the expanding form, that means by substituting n is equal to 0, 1, 2 like this. So n is equal to 0, it will be a 0 to the power x to the power 1 by 2, n considering as 0. Now considering 1, n is equal to 1, it will be a 1 x to the power 1 by 2 plus 1 will be 3 by 2 plus, considering 2, it will be a 2 into x to the power 1 by 2 plus 2. 1 by 2 plus 2 means x to the power 5 by 2. Like that, next term will be a 3 x to the power 7 by 2 and so on. Okay, now we have to substitute the values of a1, a2, a3. a0, x to the power 1 by 2, as usual I have been written over here. a1 value I have to substitute from here. We found a1 equal to minus a0 by 6. So it will be minus a0 by 6 into x to the power 3 by 2, x to the power 3 by 2. a2 value, what, how much we got? a0 by 120. So it will be a0 by 120 into x to the power 5 by 2, x to the power 5 by 2. A3 value, how much we got? It is minus a0 by 50, 40, minus a0 by 50, 40 into x to the power 7 by 2 and so on. Here we can take common from all the terms as a0 into x to the power 1 by 2. If we are going to do so, a0 x to the power 1 by 2 taken common from all the terms, the first term will be 1 minus c. If we have to we are going to take common from x to the power 3 by 2, 1 by 2 common, that means x to the power 3 by 2. So 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2 will be how much? Will be 1, right? Likewise, here x to the power 5 by 2, I have to take 1 by 2 as common, that means 5 by 2 minus 1 by 2 will be 2. Here x to the power 7 by 2, 7 by 2 minus 1 by 2 will be how much? 3, like that. So the first term will be 1, the second term when we have to take x to the power 1 by 2 from x to the power 3 by 2, it will be x. And the, in this term, it will be x square by 120. In this term, it will be x cube by 50, 40, and so on. Okay. Now, this y2 is nothing but the second solution, second independent solution of the differential equation. First independent solution, we got y1. That means y1 and y2 it represents two independent series solutions of our differential equation having the regular singular point at x equal to 0. Now the general solution will be how much? Y equal to a linear combination of the two, linear combination of y1 and y2. It will be a y1 plus b y2. Okay, so here a y1 value or series value, I have been substituted over there. It will be a into y1. Y1 is how much? A0 and this much. A0 into 1 minus x by 2 plus x square by 24, x cube by 720, x cube by 720, and so on, plus b into y2. B into y2 is this much. That is a0 x to the power 1 by 2 into 1 minus x by 6 plus x square by 120, x square by 120 minus x cube by 50 and so on. See, I don't have any space, only for that I written adjustly, but if you have space you can write continuously. Okay, suppose you have not space enough, you can write this term here, no problem. Here you just understand that this is the continuity of this line. Okay, this line continuously. Now, here we consider a0 as a1, b a0 as a2, b a0 as a2. So this can be written as this whole can be written as a0 as a1. This is capital A1 into all the terms. See, I told that initially you can write factorial format, or here itself you can write factorial format. See, 1 minus x by 2 is nothing but 2 factorial, x square by 24 is nothing but 4 factorial. See, 4 factorial is how much? 4 factorial is how much? 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, that means 12 into 2 is 24. Likewise, so instead of 24 you can write 4 factorial. Here 720 is nothing but 6 factorial minus x cube by 6 factorial also you can write, and so on. Series will be continued. Then instead of BA0, if we are going to write A2, then it will be A2 into x to the power 1 by 2 into 1 minus 6. 6 is nothing but 3 factorial. Okay, 3 factorial, 3 into 2 into 1 is nothing but 6 factorial. And x square by 120. 120 is nothing but your 5 factorial. See, 5 factorial is how much? 5 factorial is, here I written 24 into 5. 24 is 4 factorial, and another 5 if I am going to multiply, then this is nothing but 5 factorial is 120, right? So instead of 120 I can write 5 factorial, and you can check that 50 40 is nothing but so called 7 factorial. So this is this in this box whatever I written, this is general solution of the differential equation, given differential equation having singular point at x equal to 0. This is also, this is you can say your last expression. This also is your last expression. Here and here I changed this considered as a1, this considered as a2, Okay, and this is written in the factorial form. So this will be the your last expression. Means this, if you can write in exam, no problem. And you can write also this one. Okay, so here general power series solution of this is general power series solution, this one and this one also. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video. Go through this video, don't write anything whatever I written in the pencil. Okay, carefully you have to watch this video and write the note. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me, we are going to discuss. So thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.